Hey guys, Sarah Ulmer here for Y'all Politics. I'm sitting down with Whit Hughes and his wife, Shelley, to talk a little bit about the campaign trail so far and kind of how that's been going before this June 26th runoff that we're going to see for the 3rd Congressional District race. Guys, thanks so much for sitting down with us.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate the opportunity.
Absolutely. All right, Whit, talk to me a little bit about what the campaign trail has been like so far.
Well, I'm really proud of where we are. We've obviously gone from a six-person primary dynamic to a one-on-one runoff set of circumstances, and so we've had a three-week time period. And so Shelley and I have done everything we can to continue to engage voters. You know, one thing that's on our mind is that we had 16% of registered voters come out on June 5th, and that's just not acceptable. We have to be better than that. So my team has done a great job of identifying voters and doing the things you need to do to prepare to turn people back out on June 26th. But also believe it's important to continue to engage voters. The reality is, you had thousands of Mississippians that were either supporting other candidates or who didn't vote at all on June the 5th. And Shelley and I want to do everything we can to continue to talk to those folks. That's why we're doing a town hall in different communities throughout the district and have been throughout the course of this runoff. And we've received great response. And again, it goes back to the fact that there are 24 counties in this district. And folks want to see you in their communities. They want to look you in the eye. They want to ask you questions and know where you are on the issues that are important to them so they can have the information they need to be informed and make a decision on who they feel like is best for this position.
So you've been on the campaign trail for a little while now, but like you said, it's changed a little bit now because we're in this runoff season and it's two opponents now. Talk to me a little bit about what you see as the biggest obstacles in the next, I guess, really weak almost before the runoff
happens. Well, let me say this. I believe you can tell a lot about how somebody's going to represent you from the way that they campaign as a candidate. And if you look at my team and my family and the way we've done it, from day one, I've been campaigning in all 24 counties in this district. I think it's important. We're essentially asking folks to consider us for a very important job. And representing this district in the U.S. House of Representatives. And so, you know, one thing I'm disappointed in now is that my runoff opponent has decided not to do any debates. For months now, we've all assumed this was going to a runoff. And for months, the candidates have assumed that we're going to have at least one debate, if not two or more debates in the runoff. So I'm personally disappointed in that. I hope that folks are paying attention. I think that Michael Guest's refusal to debate me speaks volumes. And again, I hope voters are paying attention. And this is not personal. That's not the kind of campaign that I have run or that I am running. Okay? This is about being in a one-on-one runoff scenario. And folks deserve to see us and hear from us side by side on the stage because there are differences. You can look at our background and our experience. I'm a business person who's never run for office before. Whereas my opponent is a lawyer who's built a career out of politics. That's not a personal statement. I just think it's important for voters to know we have different backgrounds. And because of our different experiences, we're going to view things differently. And I know there are four or five very serious areas of policy where we have differences of opinion. And voters need to be aware of that. And that's why Shelley and I continue to do these town hall meetings in as many communities as we can during this runoff.
So politics is no easy thing to get into, and as you said, you're not a career politician. So what made you decide to jump into this race? And on top of that, why do you think that you're the best candidate for the job?
Well, you're right. It's a big and emotional decision to enter a race for Congress. Shelley and I know exactly what it takes to run a successful campaign. More importantly, we know exactly what life is like serving a position like this. There's an enormous amount of family and other sacrifices that go into it. At least in the U.S. House of Representatives, it's a real grind in terms of the two-year schedule. You're either on the ballot or you're just on the ballot or you feel like you're about to be on the ballot. But I've told folks in a very genuine way that if you feel led in this direction and feel prepared for this and believe you're the best person for the job, I really believe it's important to answer in that call to serve. I feel the same way that a lot of Mississippians do, and I know that because I've talked to them. I've been in their communities. I've been sitting at tables like this across from voters. And I can tell you, folks are fed up with the establishment way of doing politics. They're tired of the same old thing. And they know that nothing's going to change in Washington, D.C. unless we start sending different, better leaders to Congress. And that's part of my motivation in entering this race. I'm a business person. I've never run for office before, but I do have a backbone, and I do have some common sense, and I know how to be for what I'm for. And that's what folks want right now more than anything else. They want a person with character and integrity, but they want somebody that will put principles over politics and that will respond to the needs and interests of families and business owners in their communities.
So say things do go your way in this runoff, and Shelley, feel free to chime in on this as well. Looking towards the November ballot, what do you see as where your campaign is going to go over the summer months to be your Democratic opponent? And looking forward into potentially, you know, going to D.C. I mean, how do you think that's going to affect you and your family? And kind of what do you see as obstacles and successes and things like that moving into November?
Well, I'll say this. If I'm fortunate enough to move forward in this process, we're not going to change our approach. We're going to still campaign in all 24 counties of this district. And we're still going to be willing to work harder than anybody else around us. And that's what folks want right now. They want somebody who understands economic development, somebody who understands how to bring opportunities to their community, and somebody that'll focus on the business case of what we need for more jobs and a stronger economy. Whether you're talking about lower taxes, fewer regulations, or all the other really important issues that we need to tackle in Washington, D.C. But I'll tell you more than anything else, people are interested in things that doesn't really matter whether you have an R or a D next to your name, right? People are so tired of the kick the can that we're playing on Capitol Hill. They want somebody to go up there and improve the process, right? To start handling our federal government the same way you're going to handle your family or your business. Things like balancing the budget and eliminating waste and fraud and abuse and improving our process. I talk a lot about how we need to change the spending culture, the way we're spending and borrowing money in Washington, D.C. We're on a track now that's not sustainable, right? So are we going to just sit back and be okay with that? Or are we going to start sending leaders to Congress that are willing to take a stand and make decisions now that will pay off in the generations ahead? Shelley and I have three children, 15 and 13-year-old sons and a 10-year-old daughter. And it might sound hokey, right? But when you think about this race and the kind of leadership we need in Washington, D.C., it really is about policy decisions that will impact the generations ahead. And right now we have a lot of people in Washington, D.C. who are much more interested in holding office, so to speak, than they are in driving meaningful legislation that matters to Mississippians like you and me.
Absolutely. All right, so you touched on this a minute ago, but before the runoff, any words that you have for your opponent, anything you
want to
say?
Well, I respect my opponent. I respect everybody that's been in this race. We had a competitive primary. We're very fortunate to have moved on to this runoff. But I do think it's important to acknowledge that if you're going to respect the voters in the process, we should be debating the issues right now. We should be having debates, right? Even as late as yesterday, I invited Michael Guest and his campaign to join us in the debate on Monday night, the night before Election Day, just to give voters one more opportunity to be informed before they go to the polls. And that's the message that we're sharing. I'll remind you, we had 16% of registered voters go out on June the 5th. Thousands of people either supported other candidates or didn't vote at all on primary election day. And I don't think it's acceptable to sit back and float along for 3 weeks and be okay with that. That's why Shelley and I are trying to do everything we can to continue to engage voters. While my opponent sits on the sidelines and essentially tries to run out the clock. I personally believe that Mississippians deserve better than that. So I'm disappointed to this point that we haven't had those kind of opportunities. But it's not going to slow us down. We're going to continue to do everything we can to reach out to folks, talk about June 26th. And listen, I'm obviously going to be asking people for their support and their vote. But anybody that's heard from me in recent days will tell you, I'm just telling people to mark their calendar and make sure that they participate in the process. That's the most important thing.
Absolutely. Webb, Shelley, thank you so much for sitting down with us today. Don't forget, that's June 26th, that we have a runoff coming up for the 3rd Congressional District, so do make sure that that you get out and cast a ballot so that your voice can be heard. Thanks for tuning in to Y'all Politics.